We were just packing up in the pit lane after the flag, thinking we were leaving, and we bump into this man, and I thought, we've got to have a chat, mm-hmm. because he's one of the names on everybody's lips in the last weeks, you know. We thought we wouldn't see you again, Jorge. You know, the last couple of years, my job has been to watch you and other riders closely, and the thing that I really notice watching you here is how healthy, happy, and relaxed you've looked. You know, when I've watched you at Sepang the first time that, you know, that you haven't been racing, and I'm really curious why, like, how does it feel? Why do you look and, you know, look relaxed, healthy, and and good?
Yeah, you know, first of all, sorry not to come here for the after the flag, because I was in the meeting with the Japanese, and was very important meeting to prepare the evolution we want to make for next step, next bike. But yeah, as you say, this is a new chapter of my life. No, I've been 18 years as a professional, from 2002 when I started in Jerez in 125 till last year with Honda. Has passed 18 years with full dedication, diet, training every day, double session always. Lot of nerves, lot of pressure during the weekends, but especially on Sunday. And now all these negative things that you have as a rider disappear completely, and just remain the good things, that is riding the bike and chat with the engineers how to improve, and feel these improvements. This is a lot of satisfaction, no? When you feel you try something that improves the bike and makes you go faster, a lot of satisfaction as riding a MotoGP bike is unbelievable, no? Okay, I miss the feeling to win. That is fantastic. It's one of the more extreme feelings you can have.
And you did quite a bit of that, Jorge.
But I did it a lot. Luckily for me, in my career, I win many championships and especially many races, so I don't miss so much this. But obviously, a little bit I will miss, but I don't care, because I have more positive things, and a lot of negative things I don't have anymore.
Great. I mean, I raced for 20 years. I didn't win anything like as much as you did. You had a much longer career, exactly.
One MotoGP race, no?
Yeah, which I'm pleased about, you know. But the thing is, it takes up all of your life, doesn't it? You know, your whole life is racing. You know, everything revolves around there. And when you stop, it leaves a massive hole, I found. I know you're just feeling that, you know, for the first time. Mm-hmm. But what do you plan to fill that with? What do you have, goals, passion, something else? I'm curious.
Exactly, especially when you are such a perfectionist person like I am, no, or I was. I was very perfectionist, so if I do something, I want to do it perfect. I want to get the maximum. So that means that you need to spend all day, every day, just focus 90% of the time thinking about motorbikes, and you cannot enjoy a lot with the friends, with the family, traveling without racing, and all these kind of things that go party, all these kind of things that normal people enjoy. So now I am able to do these things
80%
of the
before,
80%
yeah.
of the time, maybe 20 as a test rider, but now 80% of the time I can do these kind of things,
yep.
So it's a perfect role, it's a perfect combination. So many things I have in mind, you know. I like, as you see in my Instagram, I like cars, I collect some cars. I like, to find opportunities on business, like real estate or the stock market, or just some new business that I can help to grow. So it's... life is very big. Life is full of opportunities, so it's important always to improve, to learn something every day. And I'm now in this process. No?
Just before we move on to more work topic, I'm curious: can you see yourself with wife and kids, family in the future, or not? It's too far away.
Well, you know, it's not an obligation. You know, it looks like if you don't have kids or you don't get married, life is incomplete, no? And it's not like this, you know. Life can be a lot of difference between each person, but obviously will be a very nice feeling. Anyway, when you have a kid, it's not only about you. is 80% about the kid. So you cannot enjoy like you are you do when you are
alone, yeah.
Alone and you are not father, no?
Yeah.
So you need to take this in account, and when you are ready and you have enjoyed a lot of things in your life and for many years, then maybe I think will be the good time for me to do it. But for the moment, I have a lot of things to do, to enjoy, and for the moment, I am okay like this.
Great. If you don't mind, I'd love to ask you about your new job, developing the... I mean, Yamaha must be super happy to have a guy your level to help them develop the bike, because the test team, is, as we've seen, is becoming more and more important because mm-hmm. less and less tests that the racers are allowed to do. So I'm curious, apart from developing the bike, answering the questions for Yamaha, do you work closely with the other Yamaha riders? Do you see it building into conversations between you and the other riders comparing?
Yeah, for sure. As you say, tests become very important, and it's crucial not to find a good direction suddenly and very quick, because you already come on winter on Sepan 1 month before start everything, and if you here you find that you make a mistake on the direction of the engine or in the chassis, you don't have time to change it. The engines are fritz and you don't have any margin to change it, no? Mm-hmm. So it's very important the end of the season, the last month of the season, to prepare the bike for next season, because in the winter you have two or three tests, you don't have time. So it's very important, don't lose this direction. I think one of my strong points as a rider was that I was very sensitive, but already as a kid, when my father changed a small thing in the hand lever of the little bike, I feel already that something was wrong. So I wish I have this extra sensitivity or extra feeling that the other riders didn't have. Even a very extreme sensitive rider as Valentino, I was a little bit even more sensitive. And I think Yamaha can take profit of it and just don't make any mistake in the wrong direction for the new bike. I already in 2 days I find some weak points that we can improve. Very good points also. Still the Yamaha is very similar to the Yamaha I left, but there's still some weak points that for sure if we put all the effort we will solve in the future.
Jorge, my last question to you is, races are super competitive, and if you feel good on the bike, I can imagine, and you're going as fast as the other guys at different stages during the year, I can imagine you'll want to race them if you enjoy riding the bike, you know. Do you think there is, how big a percentage chance is there that you will race again, or do you think this is closed?
No. You know, as I said in the press conference, no, in the official, no, press conference, no, in the team official launch of the team the other day. For the moment, 98% chances no come back to the races. 2% okay. Yes, grows a little bit, 1%, because I feel very good on the bike. No, if there is one bike that is not very very physical, a MotoGP bike, is the Yamaha, because when you finish your career, you want it or not, you don't have the same lifestyle than a professional racer. You are more relaxed, you train a little bit less, you go more traveling, you eat different kind of food, not so much diet, so you don't have a completely athlete lifestyle. And if you want to compete with these riders at this such a high level, it's very difficult, no?
Yeah, you need big motivation.
I was 1.3 slower today, but I was 20. So if you are not at 100%, it's very difficult. But you know, only two days, and with all tire, I was more or less in the same pace than the fastest ones today. So who knows? Maybe next test I will be better. I can train a little bit more to be a little fitter. And you know, season is very long, and I don't say no to a wheel car, but to come back is another story.
Perfect answer, Jorge. I want to say big thank you for joining us, and wish you best of luck with the next chapter of your life. Thanks for all the entertainment over
much.
The years.
Thank you very much. It's nice to be back and to have this role of enjoying MotoGP with another point of view. No?
Okay. Thank you again.
Thank you.